Hello and happy day. This is Marianne Diorio welcoming you to Heartside Chat number 23. Today's topic is passivity. What is passivity? It is the trait of holding back, out of the fear of rejection usually, from speaking up when it is necessary to speak up, from taking action when it is necessary to take action. You know, passivity is often the cause of major problems. Now, there is a time to exercise passivity, and that is in obedience to God's word. We must humbly submit to God's word and not take action against it. That would be rebellion. But passivity in the face of evil is a very dangerous thing. It was Edmund Burke who purportedly said that for the only way for evil to triumph is for good men to do nothing. Well, we are living in a culture today where evil people are trying to take over. And if you are a follower of Jesus Christ, I want to speak directly to you because it is up to the church to resist the evil surrounding us today. Why the church? Because we followers of Jesus Christ are the only ones who have the true spiritual power to resist evil. Resisting evil can come only in the power that God gives us, not in our own strength. But we, as followers of Jesus Christ, have been passive, and it is time for us to repent of the sin of passivity and to rise up and take our rightful places in God's army and resist the enemy in the name of Jesus. Now remember this: when we see all this evil around us, we have to remember that we are not fighting people. We are fighting the demonic spirits behind those people, the spirits that are instigating them to do evil. So while we love people, we must hate evil and the demonic spirits that are instigating the evil. You see, people who don't know Jesus Christ have no clue that they are being instigated to evil by demon spirits. Most of them probably don't even believe in demon spirits. But the truth is that the enemy, Satan, is at work today in this world in great proportions because he knows that his time is short before the return of Jesus Christ. So, if you have been guilty of passivity, if you have been guilty of simply being a spectator, watching all the evil around you and not doing anything about it through prayer and spiritual warfare, then I urge you to repent today. You see, the condition of our culture reflects the condition of the church. We have been delinquent in our duties and responsibilities. We have become a lazy church, the church of Laodicea, that seeks its own pleasure instead of the things of God. We have become lukewarm. We are neither hot nor cold. We just sit back and watch and complain, but we don't do anything about it. What does Jesus say about the lukewarm church of Laodicea? He will spit it out of its mouth. Out of his mouth. That is a hard word. So if you have been passive, I urge you today, repent. Become bold. Those who have the Holy Spirit are bold. Bold in speaking out against evil. Bold in protecting the innocent, especially babies in the womb, from evil. We must be bold in the things of God. And remember, we don't do this in our own strength. That would be impossible. We do it in the strength of Jesus Christ. He has given us two amazing gifts, his authority and his power. And we need to exercise his authority in the spirit realm in his name. And we need to exercise his power to drive out Satan and all his demon forces in the name of Jesus. So get rid of your passivity if you've been passive, especially you men, you fathers, you household leaders, those of you, even in the church, those of you pastors who have been afraid to confront evil and sin because you're afraid of losing members and losing the income to pay your mortgage. That is sin, dear brothers and sisters. That is sin. Be bold. Speak the truth in love. For only the truth will set your people free. Not accommodating them. Not being weak and passive and non-confrontational. Remember, confrontation is not a bad thing. The way you do it is important. It could be a bad method of confronting. We don't throw dishes or punch people when we confront. But confrontation is a very important thing in dealing with sin and in building healthful relationships when it is done properly in love. So put aside your passivity. Get rid of it now. Repent of it and rise up and step into the position of boldness for which our Lord died. We need to honor God and not quench the Holy Spirit by passivity. So repent and assume the boldness Jesus Christ has given you. I love you very much, and I encourage you to be bold in the Lord. Souls depend on it. Have a wonderful day.